ready to match the stars. Bill Cullen, Brett Summers, Jack Klugman, Cass Elliott, Richard Dawson, and Loretta Switz, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now, here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Hi, Johnny Olson. Thank you very much. Thank you. I thank you very much for the warmth of your reception and for coming here and being here with us in person. And those of you who have joined us around the country, thank you for being here. We'd like to welcome two new bodies to the group of regulars. Beginning up here in the top, my old friend Bill Cullen. Nice to have you with us, Bill.
Good, Gene. I could never make your entrance. Thank you.
You see Bill on Three and a Max, that marvelous show he does. And we'd like to welcome this lady, Cass Elliott, whom... Listen, Cass, your special has already played in my area, and I've seen it. I thought it was marvelous, and I just thought I'd alert people, because I guess it hasn't played everywhere yet, has it?
I hope it plays
called,
forever.
It's called Don't Call Me Mama No More, or Don't
anymore.
Call Me Mama Anymore.
That's right.
Don't. All right, we won't. Okay. Right?
Whoa. Okay. What is it? This is an old body?
No, listen.
How about a new body here?
Oh.
Yeah, nice new.
Let's say hello to Jack Klugman. Now, you've been here so much, Jack, we just think of you as a member of the family, that's all. Now, let's say hello to our two players, Karen Phillipson here and Susan Rayfield. Hello, ladies. Susan's a current champ. She's won $600, and she did that in one game. And she's being challenged by Karen Phillipson. Where do we start? Right from the top. No, the middle of round one. You've had your question, and you didn't do too well with it,
no.
Did you? Scored zero. And then you're going to have your question. All right, we'll get to that right after we get to these messages for you. Now, shall we have a go at it, ladies? I'll push the little button here and reveal your question, Susan. This is it. Everyone participates.
Oh, good. Gotcha.
Harriet came home early and caught her husband blanking his teddy bear. There it is. Says that right there, Cass. Harriet came home early and caught her husband blanking his teddy bear.
I'm ready.
You're ready. Oh, aren't you all quick today? All right. Now, let's get an answer from Susan here. Harriet came home early and caught her husband blanking his teddy bear, Susan.
Hugging
his teddy bear. He was also in love with his raincoat.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Bill, what did you say?
Aren't we all?
Yes, everybody.
And the reason
loves
he was
raincoat.
Because I've had a look at Harriet.
Really?
But actually, he did a little better. He was kissing.
Oh, kissing.
Yes.
Kissing and hugging do not match, eh? Okay, Brett, what do you say?
You can't have one without the other, darling. Kissing.
Yeah, right.
Kissing. Well, no. You could kiss without hugging. I'll show you how. Lean over here.
Oh!
You see, at no time did my hands touch her body. Don't touch it.
Would you like to do that on a permanent basis? So I can go to Hawaii.
What do you say, Jack?
I go to Hawaii.
Hugging.
Harry was sick, and he had a naughty one, so he spanked his teddy bear.
He was spanking his teddy bear.
I do that all the time.
Okay. No match yet, I'm sorry to say, Susan. Let's see how
it was a German teddy bear.
Well, he loved his teddy bear. He was kissing his teddy bear.
Kissing his teddy bear.
It's going to be a wet teddy bear.
Okay. Richard, what was he doing to his teddy bear?
Well, now, this is sounding a little bizarre. He was actually cuddling his teddy bear. Now, before you groan, let me explain. It kept him out of the army, so it did do some good.
That scored once for you, Susan. Well, cuddling and hugging matched. Now, Loretta.
Yes, I was thinking of our show, and Radar O'Reilly, it didn't keep him out of the army, because he sleeps with his teddy bear.
Sleeping with
show.
His teddy bear.
Yeah.
And the show, when she says our show, she means my favorite TV show,
the Match of the Odd Couple.
Oh.
Go away for a week, everybody forgets you.
Tomorrow's your day.
Oh, no. On behalf of Odd Couple, Perry Mason and Dick Van Dyke, we thank you.
Okay, let's go to round two. At the end of this round, it's 1-0 favor the champ. And now, challenger, would you make your selection?
I'll try B.
B is what she wants. Everyone will participate.
Right.
When his fairy godmother sprinkled magic dust on Bruce...
And I know Bruce, and she did sprinkle fairy dust on him.
He blanked. When his fairy godmother sprinkled magic dust on Bruce, he blanked. Loretta, you don't seem to have the idea. Oh, yes, now you've got the idea.
I don't understand that question.
Having fun, Bill?
I am enjoying it.
Oh, good.
I didn't know Bruce had a fairy godfather.
Godmother.
Oh, sorry, that's a fairy Bruce godmother. Is the
It's hard to tell them apart.
All right, upper tier is ready and the lower tier is ready. Karen, how do you respond to this? When his fairy godmother sprinkled magic dust on Bruce, he...
Twinkled.
He twinkled.
He didn't need
that. Isn't that sweet? He twinkled. He twinkled. That's what he did. All right, let's see if that scores for this lady. Bill?
Gene, I wouldn't have been able to twinkle if you hadn't let me use your dressing room. Along another line, the only thing to do when you sprinkle with magic dust, you disappear.
Disappear, yeah.
Decent
disappear.
Thing to do.
Okay, Brett, what'd you say?
Bruce was so upset because she changed his whole attitude that he cried.
He cried. No match there, Jack?
Well, he was allergic to it, so he sneezed.
He sneezed. All right, no match yet. You need one to stay in the game here, Karen. What have you got here, Cass?
Well, he was so shy that he blushed.
He blushed. He hasn't twinkled yet. Let's see if Richard Dawson makes him twinkle.
I don't think he's...
I was going to say he lowered his voice, but I thought that would be... When the dust hit him, he just swished around.
All right, now, Karen, you've got to match Loretta or the game is over.
Yes, I'm the only one who believes in magic. He turned into a frog.
Turned into a frog. No match there, so Susan wins again. Congratulations. Okay. There you are. Right here, Blue Woods. So that's another $100 for you, and our congratulations. And we say goodbye to Karen Phillipson. It's been a pleasure meeting you and having you here on Match Game 73. A gift for you backstage. Goodbye, Karen. Now, you're going to have a go at another, well, more than $5,000. So you stand by here, and we'll give you these messages, then you hurry right back. Okay, here we are with Susan Rayfield, who's won her second game. She's now up to $700. She's going to have a go at over $5,000. She knows how it goes, so if you're ready, we'll get to it, right?
Brett.
Well, no, it's not that part yet.
Yeah, I've come to that part yet. Just, we'll
She's
take it step
nervous.
By step if it's all right with you. Is that all right with you? Okay.
We polled a recent studio audience, and
right,
we got
Jack.
Their best response to this. Blank Alley. And the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, you're allowed to get a little help from some celebrities here. Choose them one at a time. Three is the total.
Brett.
Brett, how would you fill that in?
I'm going to say Schubert Alley.
Schubert Alley.
Oh, cut that out.
Schubert Alley is a well-known place
there,
in New York City.
Song.
And who else would you like?
Well, Richard cuddles teddy bear, so I'll take Richard.
And that's not all.
Drink your beer. Bowling Alley.
Bowling Alley. There's another answer for you. One more.
Loretta.
Tin Pan.
Tin Pan Alley. So you've got Schubert Alley, Bowling Alley, Tin Pan Alley. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own, Susan. What would you like to do?
Loretta. Tin Pan Alley.
Loretta.
Tin Pan Alley. Loretta Alley. All right, Tin Pan Alley, you think is the most valuable answer. All right,
you
we'll find out.
You think she's nervous?
That's the one we are after. Tin Pan Alley, let's begin by revealing the $100 response.
Back alley. Back.
There's an answer that did not occur to any of us.
All right. Schubert.
We're looking for Tin Pan Alley. Here is the $250 response. Tin Pan Alley, congratulations. There it is. Thank you, Loretta. Okay, now before we go on with the rest of your part of it, let's find out what is up there. What do you think, audience? What's up there? Hey, bowling alley. Oh, you're right. You're right. Okay, they were right all along. They said that right from the word go. Now, you've got the $250. You will now play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. To collect that amount of money, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Which one will it be?
I'll try Brett.
Brett?
Oh, my Lord, why would you do that, dear?
I asked the same question. Why would you do that, dear?
Last week she had a flat tire.
That's right.
All right.
I did.
Okay, Brett, you get ready to write.
God.
Can you face me, if you would, please, Susan? Face me. I'm over here. That's it, there. And I'll get the $22,500 question. Remember, this must be an exact match. Here it is. Blank cup. C-U-P. Blank cup. Okay, Brett is now finished. So, for your response, please, Susan, how do you fill in that blank cup?
Teacup.
Teacup is her answer. All right, Brett, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
I said loving.
Loving cup is her answer.
Choice and I choose.
All right. Oh. Teacup was yours, so you're up to $950 now, Susan. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Pat Miller. Okay, you ladies know each other, do you?
Uh-huh.
Nice to have you with us, Pat. Would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay, Gene. I'm a native Californian, and I'm married to a native Californian, and we have three little natives at home. And this has got to be the most exciting thing that's ever happened to me. I'm just so excited.
Good. Good luck to you, Pat.
Thank you very much.
You know that you and Susan will be answering questions, trying to match our six assorted characters here. The one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner and has a go at over $5,000.
Good.
Isn't that exciting?
Yes, it sure is.
Why don't we just sit here and talk? No, we're
better. I just have to sit here and look at all the stars.
Pat, we ask you to make a selection. We do that because some contestants find some questions harder than others, and it's entirely up to you. You want A or B?
I want B.
You want B. This is a new game, folks, so you will all play. This is it. The baker said...
He loves it. He laughs about it. Give us the story.
The baker said, have I got a problem? The plumber's convention is tonight, and they've ordered a cake in the shape of a giant blank.
Plumber's convention?
The plumber's convention.
And what else?
The baker said, have I got a problem? The plumber's convention is tonight, and they've ordered a cake in the shape of a giant blank.
Okay.
Bring like this with a measure of pleasure.
You're singing right on key.
I hope so. She always does.
All right, Brett, there you go.
Am I the last one?
Now we're all set. Now, Pat, how would you respond to this? The baker said, have I got a problem? The plumber's convention is tonight, and they've ordered a cake in the shape of a giant...
Pipe.
She says, the shape of a giant pipe. P-I-P-E, pipe, she says. Bill, what do you say?
That's right.
Well, Gene, I have the perfect answer for a cake for a plumber's convention. I'm not quite sure where you'd put the candle, but the cake would certainly be shaped like...
Hi. Who blew out the flame? All right, Brett, what do you say?
I don't say John, I'll tell you that.
What do you say?
I say wrench.
It's about time you said John.
All right.
I'm ashamed to say I agreed with my wife, wrench.
Wrench.
The first time in 17 years.
That's a logical answer for a plumber's convention thing. What did you say, Cass?
Well, I couldn't spell wrench, so I wrote sink.
Sink is her answer.
Can't spell sink either.
Yeah, sink is right.
Right.
There. Okay, Richard. She's looking for the answer pipe.
Well, don't bother me. I wrote toilet bowl.
Okay.
You know how those plumbers are.
Thank you, Richard.
Flush with success.
Septic tank.
Who knows what one looks like?
Well, you know how big a septic tank is?
Well, it was a big party.
Oh, I see.
Must have a tasty cake.
Yes.
Okay, Pat, so there's no match there, and Susan, we'll get to you right after we get to this. Okay, we are in the middle of round one. Pat Miller's had a go at her question, did not score any matches, and now we've got this for Susan. Let's see how she does with this. Fernando was an unconventional artist. He'd spread a canvas on the floor, throw paint all over it, and then rub his blank in it.
I take back what I said about your good-looking Jack.
All right.
Put it in there, Bill.
Get it. Okay, they're all ready over there. And now, Susan, if you're ready, we'll hear your response to this. He'd spread a canvas on the floor, throw paint all over it, and then rub his blank in it. What did you say?
Nose.
She says nose, folks. The nose has it. Bill, what do you say?
By golly, that lady and I are...
Nose! There's a match. Okay, one. Brett?
I've done it, and it's more fun if you do it with your whole body.
Yes. With your whole body. It's slippery, is it?
Okay. I don't want to tell you.
Squash.
We're playing a game here, isn't this password? Put your brush in.
Brush in it.
Who made the buzzer? Listen, doctor, come out of the booth and we'll fight it out. What's going on here?
All right, let's go to Cass.
Well, his nose is on his face, isn't it?
Nope, can't match that. Have to be a little more exact than that.
Yeah, that's right. His nose is on his arm. It's not your arm. Perfectly understandable. You just, generalize. He actually rubbed his feet in it.
His feet.
I can explain why. He was a Blackfoot Indian.
He was a Blackfoot Indian.
You had to be there, Gene. Don't involve.
Loretta?
He took the tail of his cat and used it like a paintbrush.
Oh, how's this?
I'm going to tell Betty White on
clever.
You.
Clever. I see. Unconventional. Okay, so there's the end of round one, and Champ is ahead by one to nothing. And now, Challenger, would you make your selection?
I'm going to stick with B.
B is what she wants. Everyone will play. On her first day in New York, Barbara lost her blank on the subway. On her first day in New York, Barbara lost her blank on the subway. You've been to New York, have you, friends? Have you been to New York? You are New Yorkers.
I lived in New York.
Okay, they're already over there. So Pat will get your response to this. On her first day in New York, Barbara lost her blank on the subway.
Her shirt.
Her shirt.
Lost her shirt?
She lost her shirt on the subway. I missed that too.
I never get a break.
He doesn't lose it on the subway. He loses it at the racetrack.
What did she lose on the subway, Bill?
I have something in mind that she lost at the Astor, but that dates me. I think the logical thing, a purse.
Her purse.
Yeah. Well, I'm losing the subway.
Okay, Brett?
Don't be too quick to applaud. I'll tell you exactly what she lost on the subway, because I lost it there too, because you can't travel on a subway without losing
it. They didn't have subways then.
Do you mind? Her innocence.
Her innocence.
That goes for what I said. They didn't have subways then when she lost her innocence. Okay.
Dignity, my dear. Jack, what do you say?
I lost the same thing, my purse.
Yeah. All right. Cass, what do you say she lost on the subway?
Her purse.
Purse. Shirt is the answer she's looking for. Richard?
I felt sure you were going to say virginity. Although she lost that in Omaha. No, she lost her purse.
Lost her purse. Okay. Wait, now to stay in the game, Pat, you must match Loretta Swit. And you've got to lose your shirt or it's all over.
No, I lost my purse.
Purse. So Susan wins again. Congratulations. So, you pick up another $100. You getting boring?
No, never.
Okay. Well, Pat, it's been a pleasure meeting you here on Match Game 73. We've got a gift waiting for you backstage together with our thanks. Pat Miller, ladies.
Bye-bye.
you. We'll get to you right after we get to this, okay? We've run out of time, so I hope you're going to be able to join us next time. I know Susan Raphael is going to be here. She's going to meet a new player, and we'll see what happens. And I hope all of you will consent to join us.
Oh, I'll be here.
No, I wouldn't.
Because today you were so terrific that we're going to give you another chance at it. We'll look for Loretta Swit on MASH, and we'll look for you on your Cass Elliot special. Look for Bill Cullum there.
I twinkle.
No. And we'll look for you on The Odd Couple.
That's right, pass right over me.
And we'll look for you on Perry Mason.
You have to look pretty hard, I'll tell you that.
So we'll look for you too, friends. Be there. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are for Montgomery Ward's Big Fall Catalog, a full-size Velvet Touch electric blanket. Stay cozy warm with 11 comfort settings from the Montgomery Ward Catalog. And Long Nails, the amazing product that changes short broken nails into long, beautiful, natural-looking nails for strength and glamour, Long Nails. And Honeysuckle White Turkey from Ralston Purina, the premium basic turkey in the red checkerboard package, Honeysuckle Turkey, the Ralston Purina Checkerbird. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.